Hello everyone, in this tutorial we are going to be making a very simple game using Wade. So once we've got our web browser open, the first thing we need to do is navigate to clockworkchili.com and we need to click on get started. So I'm just going to go ahead and click skip tutorials. I'm going to click new project and I'm just going to call it not a clone. That's a little clue as to the type of game we may be making. So now we're in our empty project. I'm just going to set the resolution to 720p as I always do, just to keep it nice and simple and consistent for the tutorials. And I'm just going to go ahead and save that. So I'm going to drag in my art assets, and most of these can be found on the store, but I've downloaded them prior to this just for speed. So I'm going to drag our background image in here. I'm going to set the position to 0, 0, and I'm going to call it background. Okay, just let's save that and let's run the project. Okay, nothing wrong with that at all, so everything seems to be working normally. Now I'm going to add the character, and this is going to be a unicorn, so we'll just name this unicorn. And obviously we don't want that, that looks a bit ugly, so we're going to go to sprites, add a new animation, uncheck resize, but check active and loop. So now we get our unicorn image, and we call this unicorn as well. Okay, so we save that and we run it. So we can see we've got little unicorn here. It is very small, but it's good for the purposes that we want. So the next thing we need is some gravity, because at the moment the unicorn just flies in midair and doesn't move. So we go to functions, on update, and we need to apply a little bit of gravity. So to do that, we just do this dot set velocity, and in here we need an object of x and y. So x is just always going to be 0, y is going to be this dot get velocity dot y plus 40. So I'll just save that and let's run it. So yeah, the unicorn falls off the bottom of the screen, but that's totally okay, that's exactly what it is meant to do. Now, we need the ability to jump, so I'm going to click on the background, I'm going to go to on mouse down, and in here, we're going to change the Y velocity of the unicorn to something very high and negative on the Y axis. So we do wade.getSceneObject unicorn. Then we do set velocity, and it's just going to be x is 0, y is minus 800. We'll try that. So every time I click on the background, the unicorn should jump. And indeed it does, but I'd like it if it actually started off with a jump, just because it would be a lot nicer, really. I mean, if I play that again, you'll see the unicorn drops really, really quick. So it'd be nice if it started jumping. So what we're going to do is go to the unicorn, go to on add to scene, and we're just going to paste this dot set velocity into there. So when I do this now, yes, the unicorn jumps as soon as we start. Excellent, that seems to be working pretty good. Now the next thing I'm going to add is a ground obstacle. This is so if the unicorn goes below the bottom of the screen, the game will end. So I'm just going to create another scene object and drag it down. Excellent. We'll call it ground. We're going to give it one property called isWall, and we'll set that to true. Okay, that's all looking good. Now we're also going to set this to invisible because we don't need to see it for any reason in particular. Now, in a moment, we're going to be adding more walls that actually move to the left to give the illusion that the unicorn is flying. But for now, we're just going to handle the walls in the update function of the unicorn. So, back in here we are. Basically, if we collide with an object, if this unicorn collides with anything, it has to be a wall, because the only things in the scene are the unicorn, the walls, the ground, which is also a wall, and the background. And actually, let me just go to that. The background should be on a different layer. We need to put that on layer 15, so it won't register in the on overlapping objects function, because by default that only checks the layer you are on. Of course we could check for the isWall flag, which is probably why I've just set it, but this should still work perfectly fine. So first of all, we need to see if we have any overlapping objects. So if this.getOverlappingObjects.length is greater than 0, so if we've got an overlapping object, we need to get all of the walls and stop them moving. That's fairly simple. So var walls equals wade.getSceneObjects is wall and true. So that's what that property is for. Okay, so we've got our walls all selected. Now we need to have a for loop. So for var I equals 0, while I is less than walls.length, I plus plus. So this is where we go through each wall and we in turn disable the velocity and its onMoveComplete function, which I will demonstrate in a minute. So walls.onMoveComplete equals 0 and walls i.setVelocity, and we just need to set this to 0 and 0. Oops, I missed the I out there. So let's go ahead and fix that. Excellent. Now after this for loop, we need to do wade.getSceneObject background. And the idea is we need to disable our mouse input so we can't fly back up after we've died. So on mouse down equals 0. Very, very simple. Pardon me. Now, we are going to add some actual walls into the game. So I'm just going to drag my crates image and I'm going to put it here. Now I'm just going to call this wall. And I'm going to set the position to 0, 0 for now. Oh, not 0, 0. Sorry, let's go. I'm getting the wrong axes. Let's try 400. That should be okay. Now, what I want, I actually want two of these sprites. So I'm going to go to new sprite and basically make a duplicate of it. So we want crates.png. I don't know why it says size 32, that's interesting. I'll change it, it's 175 by 500. There we go. So now obviously we need to offset these a bit, so we'll go to the first sprite and we'll offset it by 235 maybe? And then that doesn't look enough. We'll try 250. That might be okay. We'll go to the second sprite and offset that by 250. Okay. So these need to be offset much more than this. Let's try 350 on both of them. That looks reasonable, but I still think it looks a bit too hard, so 375? Of course, if you spent a lot more time on this, you could tweak it, get the values exactly right. I'm just going to get something rough that works. I think that might be doable. Let me just see. It's going to be very difficult, but I think we can do it. Excellent. So now, these walls need to move, and that's actually fairly simple to do. And actually, but before we do that, let's just quickly add our isWall property before I forget. isWall true. Okay, so we do in on add to scene of the wall, we do this dot move to, and we just want to go off the left of the screen really, so minus wade dot get screen width over 2 minus 250. That should be enough. Y is just going to be this dot get position dot y, and the speed will be 250. So now if we save this, oh, we're going towards the wall. Can we get through? No, we hit the top. So let's try that again, but actually play properly. It's going to be close. And we got through. So obviously the problem is, after you get past this wall, there are no more. So that's a little bit boring. So what we're going to do next is go to the onUpdate function for the wall. Now in here, what we're going to do is when the wall gets past the middle of the screen, it's going to spawn a new one. So we do if this dot get position dot x is less than 0, we need a new wall. So we do var new barrier equals this dot clone. And that gives us our new wall. We then need an offset, so we do math.floor, math.random times by 3. Now what this is going to do is it's going to give us a random number between 0 and 2. And the reason for this is I don't want all our walls to be in the center. I want sometimes the gap to be high, sometimes for it to be low. So I'm just adding my switch statement. And we need to have all of the cases here. So case 0, offset equals minus 150, break. And I'm just going to copy paste that. There we go. So this can be 1, this can be 2, this can be 0. And this needs to be positive 150. So now the barriers will be created at different heights. Of course, we need to actually set the position. Now we have our offset. So new barrier dot set position, and we do way dot get screen width over 2, so it'll appear past the right side of the screen, so that's okay. Plus this dot get sprite dot get size dot x, and the y value is just going to be the offset. So I think that's right. Let's just make this code window a bit bigger. That's a rather long line we've got going on there. Okay. So we've created the position. Now we need to add it to the scene. So wait, add scene object, new barrier, comma, true. And then we do this dot on update is 0 because we no longer need to check if we are past the middle of the screen. Now the last thing we need to do is go to our onMoveTo function, which should be in here somewhere. Oh, sorry, not onMoveTo. onMoveComplete is what I'm looking for. onMoveEnd. Completely forgot what it's called. There we go, onMoveComplete. We need to do wade.remove scene object this, just so we don't want a load of walls in the scene existing forever. So, I'm just going to go back to onUpdate because that's where most of the interesting stuff happens. I think we may have everything we need, so we're going to try this and see if it works. Okay, does it create another one? Yes, it does, and it is higher up. And this is going to... Oh, damn. And this is going to go indefinitely until you screw up. Now, obviously, you could put a high score thing on here. You'd get points the longer you stay alive. And you'd restart the second you died, so you'd constantly be wanting to beat your high score, which would be very, very addictive, as the internet has proven already with this particular genre of game. Oh, what was that? That was death. Anyway, hopefully you enjoyed this tutorial, guys, and I hope you enjoy making the game.